Well, it's a long day of counting going on. The latest news break that is coming in, it seems that JP Nadda, the president of the Bharatiya Janata Party, will reach the BJP headquarters in Delhi at 6 p.m. They've been watching the results. 40% of the votes are in, counted for. The NDA on leads of 130 seats right now. The Mahagathbandhan at just 102. Things, if don't go dramatically wrong, it does seem to suggest, just going by these trends at 40% votes in, that the Bharatiya Janata Party could come in to be the single largest party. Of course, we'll only know when that last vote is counted, but if trends are to be believed and 40% votes are in. What's also happening on the sidelines is that the RJD has spoken to its cadre through Twitter, and they have gone and said that there is a win on hand. The rural vote is still to be counted, is what the Twitter handle of the RJD says, and that ultimately the government will be of the Mahagathbandhan. They are still very sure that they're going to get it in the bag. But if you just go by early leads and the numbers are right there, it does seem that the NDA is in pole position, with the Bharatiya Janata Party getting the maximum number of seats in terms of what it looks like in plain numbers. It could very well be the single largest party. But the spotlight right now is also on JP Nadda, because this is an election which JP Nadda, the president of the BJP, has fought on ground. We've not seen the presence of Amit Shah, because the last third phase of Bihar, you saw Amit Shah campaigning in Bengal while JP Nadda was managing affairs in Bihar. It seemed that the RJD had it in the bag if exit polls are going to go by. But if NDA actually takes it, then it's a big, big win for JP Nadda and coming of age for the president of the Bharatiya Janata Party. I want to connect right now. I have Kumar Abhishek, who's joining us from Patna. He has with him Ajay Alok of the JDU. Too early to celebrate, Kumar, or pretty much they are quite sure that they are in pole position, waiting to cross the finishing line?
Well, JDU is looking quite confident and quite upbeat. I have with me Ajay Alok. Ajay, are you confident that you are going to get a comfortable majority? How much you are expecting?
Well, the trend suggests that NDA is very comfortable, and hopefully the result will be in our favor. But I'm expecting the number to be somewhere around 150, not less than that. Since only 40%, 45% counting has been done, but still the results, 22 results have come in our favor already. So let's hope we cross 145, 150 mark.
But BJP is going to be the single largest party. You and JDU and BJP both had fought almost same seat. But now the better strike rate is with BJP, and they are doing very well. JDU is not doing...
Of course. That credit should go to Mr. Chirag Paswan, that he has effectively damaged us in around 20 seats. There's no doubt about it. But anyway, as a coalition, we did well. I mean, in spite of all the challenges, we did well. So, and I hope that this coalition will achieve 150 plus.
So Chirag Paswan has damaged JDU quite in a big way?
See, I will not say in a very big way. He did try to damage us, but in the process, he ended up damaging himself and his party.
How?
He's virtually out of Bihar political scene now. He's not winning a single seat. His vote share will be something to look after. And this is the price he will have to pay for his overambition.
Price he will have to pay. What do you want to say?
Well, we'll talk about it later when the final results come. Right now, our focus is on the final results, what the tally is. And let's hope NDA will shoot to 150.
But BJP is almost around 80, and JDU is approximately around 50.
No,
it's a big gap.
The number is definitely going to increase. We have our informations. There are many seats, there are many rounds which will go in our candidate's favor. There are many seats, there are approximately 25 seats which are hanging, which will come into us.
Okay. The last question, Ajay. CM face is Nitish Kumar.
I'll urge you to keep Ajay Alok with you, because we want to get a quick question from him. And the question I want... Kumar, if you can hear me, we're going to take a quick news break coming in, and I want to come right back to you. So what's happening is already, which was expected, with the BJP now in pole position of being the single largest party, there are a lot of leaders already suggesting it's time that Bihar has a BJP chief minister. Now, the SC Morcha chief of Bihar for the BJP, Ajit Kumar Chaudhary, has said that the BJP's workers have worked for a very long time, and what they want is now a chief minister who is from the BJP and not the JDU. Kumar, it's a good question to ask Ajay Alok, because if the BJP, which is now in pole position to be the single largest party, continues to be so, then the JDU is clearly on the back foot. Many leaders from the BJP Bihar unit saying, make a BJP leader the chief minister. Why, Nitish Kumar?
Well, I'm asking directly this question to Ajay Alok. Ajay, voice is coming from the BJP, inside the BJP, that now its time has come for the BJP chief minister and Morcha chief of SCST leader has asked that now BJP should, the chief minister should be from BJP.
Well, that question raised by the BJP local unit leader or Morcha leader, whatever, I guess that question needs to be answered by the Prime Minister and the Home Minister. Why this question from us?
Don't you think that this question will be asked in days to come? Because
I don't think so. There's absolute clarity on this issue. I don't think so.
But sense is growing in the BJP that they have their chief minister. They are getting almost 80 seats.
The counting is yet not over. Let us wait for the final results and then we can have discussion on this. But as far as the chief minister's issue is good, the NDA chief ministerial candidate is Nitish Kumar, and he's going to be sworn in as a chief minister. There's no doubt about it. As Prime Minister himself has said many a times, not one time. And the same goes with the Home Minister.
But what will you say about these voices which is coming out from inside the BJP?
In a coalition, you always listen to the voice of leader. Who is the leader of NDA coalition nationally? Narendra Modi. Who is the leader of the BJP? Narendra Modi and Amit Shah. In our party, who is the leader? Nitish Kumar. So anybody saying anything XYZ, it's for the BJP people to make them understand, not us.
Preeti, clearly Ajay Alok saying that only voice of Narendra Modi, Amit Shah and top big leaders matters, not the local leaders. Preeti.
Well, fair enough, because that's something that the top BJP leadership has done repeatedly as well.